Here's a short video on double-tonguing. Double-tonguing uses single-tonguing, the 2-2-2 or the ta, t, whatever you decide to use. It uses that tonguing and another type, which is called dorsal tonguing, which is tonguing with the back part of your tongue. If you say ka or gu or gi or anything that uses the back of your tongue to aspirate, to get that k sound, with double-tonguing, we're going to use the k. So we go back and forth between the T and the K. The tu ku tu ku tu ku tu, ta ka ta ka ta, etc., etc. The T and the K. And in method books, you'll often see, with double-tonguing exercises, you'll see a T and a K, and this will tell you which one you're supposed to use. So the single-tonguing, you've probably already got. Nothing new there. The double-tonguing, a good way to practice this is to practice just the K sound. So I'm going to do some tonguing on a G, and I'm just going to go coo, 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 coo. And I'm going to try to make that K sound as exactly like the T sound. Now, I can't get it quite exact. It's pretty hard to do, but the sharper and the cleaner and the clearer, the better. So at first, I'll just do coo, 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 coo. And then I'll alternate between the K and the T so I can compare the two, and you can hear the difference. So here's just the K sound on a G. Okay, and as with regular tonguing, you want to keep the air moving all the time. You could probably hear in there was kind of a diffuse beginning that. It wasn't a clear t t t sound. But when you're going quickly, it's difficult to tell. So now I'm going to do the T and the K. So you can compare the two. So as you're practicing, just take it very slow. Use the metronome, the T and the K, or just the K, two T's, two K's, mix it up. You know, get creative with it. Have fun with it. Gradually, if you use the metronome, and I'll post a video about how to use the metronome the most efficiently later, but with the metronome, you can gradually get that speed up until you can go quite fast, or something like that. So, and again, with regular tonguing, like regular tonguing, you can do it on a single note, which is the best way to learn and the easiest way to learn, but also changing notes. This gets a little tricky with double tonguing because there's quite a bit of coordination involved. But if you start slowly, use a metronome, you should be fine. So here's some double tonguing just on a single note. And then I'll maybe do a scale or something with double tonguing. Okay. So there you have it. As with any kind of practice, start really slow. Make sure you've got it perfect before you start to speed it up. And give yourself a few weeks and you should be doing really well. So stay tuned for the triple tonguing video and good luck.